We teach children addition of whole numbers by combining collections of objects and using story problems. Similarly, in this lesson, we look at addition of decimals through applications, combining decimal amounts. Lee mows lawns and has a container with 6/10 of a gallon of gasoline and a second container with 8/10 of a gallon of gasoline. What is the total amount of gasoline? If a whole square represents one unit, then the shaded amount represents 6/10 of a gallon. And over here we have 8/10 of a gallon. And since we want the total amount, we combine these two amounts, that's going to be addition. Now one way to show the total amount, here we have 6 shaded paths. We need 4 more paths to form a whole. So we could take 1, 2, 3, 4 paths from here, put them over here, and then we're going to have one whole square and 4 paths out of 10. And this is 1.4 gallons. The total shaded amount can also be represented by placing the two shaded amounts end to end. And now you can see the 4 paths filling out this first square. We have one whole square and 4 paths out of 10. Elena's bicycle has an odometer that measures 2/100 of a mile. Her route going to the store is 7/10 of a mile, and she takes a different route returning home that's 5/500 of a mile. What is the round trip distance? If this whole square represents 1 mile, then the shaded amount represents 7/10 of a mile, and this square represents 5/500 of a mile. And since we want the total distance, we'll use the operation addition. Now this square needs 3 more columns, 3 more tenths, to form 1 mile, so we can take 3 columns from this square, and then we'd have 10, 20, 25 left. So the total distance, round trip, be one whole square and 25 paths out of 100, or 1.25 miles. Or, as in the first example, we can put the total shaded amounts end to end to see that we have one whole square and 10, 20, 25 paths out of 100. Another possibility is replacing the 7/10 square by a 70/100 square. And 7/10 is also equal to 70/100. Now we can just combine the total shaded amount by adding 70 and 55. 70 plus 55, 12. So 1/25 is one whole square and 25 paths out of 100. And we can see the similarity between the algorithms for adding whole numbers and adding decimals. Sally buys 2 pieces of salmon. If a whole square represents 1 pound of salmon, then the shaded amount of this square represents 675/1000 of a pound. And the shaded amount of this square represents 75/100 of a pound. What is the total weight of the salmon? Before we can find the total weight, by adding the numbers of paths in both squares, the paths of these squares need to have the same size. So, we replace the square for 75/100 by a square with the same amount of shading that represents 750/1000. Now we can add the numbers of paths in the two squares. 675 paths in the first square and 750 paths in the second square, So we'll add these two numbers. 7 and 5 are 12. It's just we're adding whole numbers. Here we regroup the 1. 1,425 parts. Since one whole square has 1,000 parts, 1,425 parts is one whole square in 425 parts out of 1,000. So the sum of these two decimals equals 1,425 pounds. Now we use the algorithm here for adding whole numbers. We added the whole numbers of parts in the two squares. But to add the decimals for these two squares, we write the decimals, add the two numbers as if they were whole numbers, in other words, disregarding the decimal points, and then place the decimal point in the answer. Adding whole numbers of parts, as we did in this example, helps to show the close relationship between adding whole numbers and adding decimals. Students can illustrate sums of decimals by shading blank decimal squares. They can shade squares for hundreds and tenths decimals, and shade a square for the sum, or it might take two squares, or shade squares for tenths and hundreds, or shade squares for two hundredths decimals. Let's use a larger copy of these squares to illustrate 37 hundredths plus 46 hundredths. The square for 37 hundredths will have three full columns shaded and 700 squares in the next column. And the square for 46 hundredths will have four full columns shaded and 600 squares in the next column. To shade the square for their sum, we'll shade 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 columns that takes care of the full columns. Then we've got 7 and 6, that's 1,300 squares. It's another column and 3 more hundred squares. So the sum of these two decimals is 83 hundredths. Or we can shade just one square for the sum of these two decimals. So to illustrate 37 hundredths plus 46 hundredths, we begin by shading three full columns for 37 hundredths, and then to continue with 46 hundredths, we'll take three of the hundredths to finish this column off. That leaves us with 43 hundredths, so we've got four more columns and three more hundredths. So the sum is 83 hundredths. In this lesson, we used word problems involving decimal amounts. By adding whole number parts of decimal squares, we were able to show the close connection between algorithms for adding whole numbers and adding decimals. We will now play the game Decimal Squares Blackjack at the intermediate level that involves tenths and hundredths decimals.
In this game, you will play against the robot. The object is to get a sum that's less than or equal to 2 and greater than the robot's sum. We will select the intermediate level. Dan will type his name and click Let the Game Begin. Dan's sum is less than 1, so he will click Hit Me. He hits me again. It's still not a very large sum. So he goes, hit me once more. Now Dan will hold. And the robot won this round.